हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, 12th स्टैंडर्ड मैथ्स डिफरेंशिएशन चैप्टर में आपका फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन आज के लिए y is equal to tan inverse sin x upon 1 plus cos x। स्टूडेंट्स आपको ध्यान देना होगा, कई क्वेश्चन आपके सामने आएंगे जिसमें ये फॉर्मूले आपको लगाना होगा, 1 प्लस कॉस एक्स, 1 माइनस कॉस एक्स एंड साइन एक्स, ये तीनों का सेट होता है। अगर क्वेश्चन में ये आया तो आपको लिखना है 2 कॉस स्क्वायर एंगल हाफ, और ये आया तो आपको लिखना है 2 साइन स्क्वायर एंगल हाफ, और ये आया तो आपको लिखना है 2 साइन एंगल हाफ एंड कॉस एंगल हाफ। ठीक है, ये 3 फॉर्मूलेज हैं, बेसिक बहुत ही स्टार्टिंग फॉर्मूले हैं, इन्हें आपको डेफिनेटली याद करके रखना है। ओके स्टूडेंट्स, चलिए अब हम देखते हैं ये क्वेश्चन कैसे सॉल्व होगा। इसे सॉल्व करने के लिए पहले इसका फॉर्मेट चेंज करेंगे, हम क्वेश्चन को इजी बनाएंगे। फॉर दैट यूज द सेम फॉर्मूला, साइन एक्स के लिए 2 साइन एंगल हाफ एंड कॉस एंगल हाफ, डाउन साइड 1 प्लस कॉस, 1 प्लस कॉस मीन्स 2 कॉस स्क्वायर एंगल हाफ। Okay, students, now you can find yourself that 2 getting cancelled. Here double cos is there, here single cos. One cos will get cancelled with one cos. What's remaining? Check. Tan inverse is equal to sine x upon 2 upon here cos x upon 2. After this, sine upon cos, everybody knows sine upon cos is what? Tan x upon 2. Now see students, tan inverse and tan are getting cancelled. Tan inverse and tan are getting cancelled. What's remained with x upon 2. Now the question is easy and you can differentiate. Okay, so one more step I'm writing. X you take down means this way. This and this has same meaning. Correct. Now derivative. Here we are derivating. Differentiate with respect to X. What you will write? Derivative of Y dy by dx is equal to, now half is coefficient no rule, same we have to copy, and derivative of x is 1. So what you are getting finally, derivative of y is equal to half into 1 is half. This is your final answer. Correct, very easy, but you have to remember the formula. Students, question number 2. Here, to differentiate, see 1 minus sign is there. For 1 minus sign, formula is not there. So let's convert it into cos style. How to convert it into cos style? Check. See it, cos 90 minus theta means sin theta, and sin 90 minus theta means cos
but changed the ratio. Now tan inverse 1 minus cos, this formula you apply. 1 minus cos means 2 sine square angle half. Angle half means whatever you have written here, that's half you have to write. Then how you will write? 90 minus x half. Downside, I said students, sine formula. Sine x is 2 sine angle half, cos angle half. So here, sine formula 2 sine angle half and cos angle half. Correct? Now just cancel up and down. If you are cancelling up and down, sine square and sine. So let's take the cancellation. Square will get cancelled with 1 sine. 2 will get cancelled with 2. What's remaining? Y is equal to tan inverse. Say student, sine pi by 2 minus x upon 2, and here cos 90 minus x upon 2. Correct? Up to this we reached. Now next step, y is equal to tan inverse. Students tell me, sine upon cos is always tan. Tan and angle will be same, means 90 minus x upon 2. Next step, now you can cancel these ratios, tan and tan inverse. What's the meaning? Just this one. Means you got now y is equal to 90 minus x upon 2. This much you are getting now. To derivate it, divide both by 2. 90 divided by 2, you will get 45. This is 45. And x divided by 2, x upon 2. Now derivative. Now we are derivative. So here write, differentiate. One more step you write, that will be better for you. Y is equal to pi by 4 minus x came down. Means this way. Correct. Now you derivate. So here we are derivating. Therefore, derivative is equal to constant 0 minus coefficient no change and x is 1. So answer we got how much? Minus half. Minus half is your answer. Okay students, question number 3. Here first of all we will change the format of the question. Students, 1 minus cos 2x, 1 minus cos anything, formula is what? 2 sine square angle half. So 2 sine square angle half, 2x half will be what? Single x. Double x will become single x, means angle half. Here 1 plus cos, 1 plus cos means 2 cos square angle half. So 2 cos square angle half, 2x half is single half, single x. Double x will become single. You have to write angle half. Now solve. Now you cancel out here 2 and 2. Remaining copy downside. Sine square x, cos square x. Now square square will get cancelled with square root. Then what you are getting? Y is equal to tan inverse sine x upon cos x. Now y is equal to students here tan inverse sine upon cos is what? Tan. Okay. Now you can say tan inverse and tan cancel. So you are getting y is equal to just x. Y is equal to just x. Now differentiate with respect to x. Derivative of y means divide by dx and derivative of x means 1. Correct? So this is your final answer. Now question number 4. Students, I told you 1 minus sign and 1 plus sign formula is not there. So let's convert it into cos style. How to convert into cos style? Y is equal to tan inverse root 1 minus sin, you are converting into cos. Therefore, theta will become 90 minus theta. Theta is 4x. So here we are like 90 minus 4x. Similarly, down also same thing. Sin you are making cos, therefore theta will become 90 minus theta. After this, y is equal to tan inverse. Students, now you are going to apply 1 minus cos formula. 1 minus cos formula, 2 sin square in the half. So I am writing 2 sin square. Angle half, this is your angle, make it half. 90 half is 45 and 4x half is 2x. So angle we meant half. Similarly down also, 1 plus cos, 1 plus cos formula is what? 2 cos square angle half. So here we are writing 2 cos square angle half. 90 half is 45 and 4x half is 2x. Correct. Now go for next. Students, 2 cancel. Tan inverse, you can check here, squares will get cancelled with square root. That means square and square root both cancelled. Only sine angle, cos angle is remaining. So here we are writing sine angle means 45 minus 2x upon cos angle. Cos 45 minus 2x. This much is remaining. Okay. Now sine upon cos, everybody knows tan. It will become tan what? 45 minus 2x. After this, tan inverse cancelled. What's it meaning? Bring here. Therefore, y is equal to you have 45 minus 2x. Correct? 45. Differentiate with respect to x. Derivative of y means divide by dx. Constant derivative is 0. Coefficient, no touch, same you have to copy. And x derivative is 1. So finally, dy by dx you got how much? Just minus 2. It's your answer.